In my role now in Yahoo, we created what we call the first long-form entertainment platform, where we have acquired already the right and the license to stream for free more than 500 movies, more than, I don't know how many, thousands of hours of drama and plays. And one of the gaps that we have identified in our portfolio is animation. And creative young people who can produce communication products that can work across cultures and platforms. And definitely animation was one of that. We started by doing things around, you know, stand-up comedy. There are a number of, something like 80, we are producing this year 80 videolets or web videos done by young people. And you can call them stand-up comedy. Your guide to unhealthy food is one of them. My own president is another. There are a number of these. And I wish we can create that experience across platforms using young people who have ideas that they think it can, that they think can travel across boundaries of culture, of language, of space, of geography. And the key question that was posed earlier here is around platforms. Actually, platforms are agnostic to this. And it's not really about mobile, TV, or computer. It's about a viewing experience that takes into consideration the context of the platform that it works on. And some of the key defining factors that we have here is bandwidth. But this is an issue that you can find with very complex production or with long-form experiences. But short films, short animated films with key simple lines can really travel and can break through all of experience. So we probably will talk more about different other issues. I don't want to take the bandwidth of the discussion, but this is just a starting point and maybe opening a number of themes that we can delve into afterwards. Thank you.
Fantastic. Thank you, Hussam. I think excellent. So great interest from everybody. I'm going to ask a question which is around the theme of Arabic content, which is obviously what we're starting to hear is both a convergent story in terms of the distinction, the traditional distinction between different platforms being one actually more about a commonality and the idea translating, essentially idea-driven translating into different platforms as opposed to differentiation per se. And secondly, the thing that I'm trying to understand a little bit more about is the opportunity for content creation specifically within animation. So let's maybe pick up that theme and maybe, Najib, I don't know if you want to pick up around Arabic content versus the historic content focus in the region and opportunities across the board in Arabic content creation.
So I can understand the irony that we're talking about Arabic content in English. That happens every time. But if you move from that, Arabic content as a content, we have been talking about it as it is the problem for the past 3 years. I'm gonna tell you, it's not the problem. There's plenty of Arabic content online. There is videos that are growing. The growing rate and the growth rate is becoming healthy. We're growing as a content, especially in terms of video content. We're growing at a healthy rate that is for other, that almost competes with other languages as well. So that issue as a content growth is being solved. We're seeing that amount happening. Like, amount of content in the region almost doubled in the past year and a half. So that tells you that what we're doing is on the right track. If we focused a little bit more as well into content that is being produced, we're now witnessing that that content is being produced the web, and specifically for the web, not for other platform and then being used and then after that, it's being put online as well. And that helps the content in the entire growth cycle. And as Hussam said, we're also bringing the content from offline. We're now putting the offline content, we're digitizing them, and we're putting it online again. So that entirely is helping the content issue and accelerating the growth. More specifically, if we go to a platform, and I'm gonna talk a little bit more about YouTube. Basically, I have more information and I can rely on numbers happening for YouTube more than the entire internet as we can see it. What we're witnessing is the several types of growth that that people are uploading and people are consuming at the same time. When YouTube first started appearing in the region, back around 2006, there was little amount of original Arabic material available in there. And the consumption was more about what's being available as an English material or with other language, things that are still without a voice or things that are a simple animation. With the growth, we're getting more of the content Arabic coming up and up. And we're now at a point of, which is if you noticed about it back in March when we launched YouTube in 7 domains in MENA, the Arabic consumers themselves, they're now searching and they're dedicating time to actually finding that Arabic content within the entire YouTube videos. So they're trying to find it, they're viewing it more and more, they're sharing it more and more. Whether that it's totally more relevant for them at that point, but they're also preferring it than other even more quality content that is available in other language. Even if like language was not as much as a barrier, but even content coming up from the region specifically is also something they're preferring. And the problem that started to appear, it's not the language as a content, it's the dialogue as a content. So we're witnessing that we're getting a small amount of silos around each of the countries. So for example, content creation that's happening around the GCC is not making it as much into, for example, in Saudi. The content that is happening in Egypt is not spreading into the GCC, and users are not viewing that content as much as they're viewing the content around it. Content in the GCC, it's totally irrelevant of what's happening inside Egypt. And at the same time, our North African brothers that we typically don't talk about, they have an absolutely new type of content that is also different from each one of those contents. So that's the problem that we're seeing now, that there are certain silos of the users that is happening around dialect and around cultures within MENA as a total. We're no longer are looking at MENA as it's all Arabic, it's all one geographical region. So that's what happened.
Justin. Anybody else?
Well, I'm glad, I mean, just to prove that we are really in sync here, I'm glad that we are saying now that the content is not a problem, and I've always been in doubt about the 1% issue that has been raised around Arabic content, you know, being 1% and Arabs are 4% and all of that stuff. Because one of my critiques for our industry now, being on the online side, is that we always talk about quantities rather than quality. You wouldn't see anybody in the TV industry or the newspaper industry talking about the volume all the time. But in the online industry, we always measure it by volume. And I don't know what we're talking about. Are we talking about kilobytes, or are we talking about page impressions, or are we considering overlapping and duplication? So the issue for me is not really volume. The issue is quality. And there is enough content. There is enough good content. But the key issue is, how can you select and elect the content that you can get users to see? Because even though the content is king, content doesn't make it on its own on the web. There are lots of good content, but people don't know where it is. And you need really a good distribution platform. And this is what I'm trying to do. When we launched the Arabic Metro page, or the front page of Yahoo by the end of last year, our combined reach, the reach of the original Maktoub, plus the reach of Yahoo.com in the region, the English property, was about 25 million uniques. Our target for ourselves, when we launched mid-October, that in these few weeks left to the end of the year, we'll reach something like 32, 34, something like this. And we surprised ourselves by the fact that we reached 42 million uniques. 1 month later, it became 44. Another month, 48.5. In May, it was 55 million uniques. Now, not all of this is based on creating new content. It's mainly about finding the right content, because the unique thing about the way we work in Yahoo is that we are a combination of two things. The one that everybody knows in the market is embedded intelligence. That's my own term, by the way, so you don't have to use it unless you take a license from me. Embedded intelligence means that what we have been doing is that we are trying to capture the intelligence that humans have and put it in software. So the software starts working for you, finding the things that you want to find. So we categorize, we index, we create search engines, and all of it is based on trying to capture the human intelligence and put it in a piece of software that works for you. The additional bit that we have, and we do that, You know, our front pages, our metro page, has a very, very sophisticated algorithm that we call it, I mean, initially we called it Coke, Content Optimization Knowledge Engine, and then we realized that Coke may have some associations that people wouldn't like, so it changed into CORE, you know, Content Optimization Relevance Engine, but it's the same thing. And the algorithm works on analyzing your behavior and pattern of interaction with the information, which means that when you go to our page the next time, it will use the experience that it had from your interaction with it. And if you like to see more of Haifa Wahbi and Nancy Ajram, then the system will bring to you the content that you are likely to be enjoying when you come to our page. But here is the important bit, the human intelligence, the editors that we have, the editorial team in Cairo, in Amman, in Dubai, they are sitting there knowing that on the day when there is a trial in Egypt for the ex-president Mubarak, even though that you may not be interested in generally in politics, this is the time when I, as an editor, will deactivate the system on some parts of the page. So wherever you are in the Middle East, whether you like it or not, I know it better than you, that you wouldn't want to miss this. So I will disable the system, and this will be number one item there. And whatever CORE wants to say to me, I don't care. I know it better because I know my audience. And that's what we try to do. So the issue here is actually about curating the right content and about servicing the content that I know would be right for you. There is a lot that we have on the internet today, especially the content that young animators or young creators create. They put in a small website, they don't know how to reach the audiences. And my issue is not really finding audience, as most people have, because people create websites with the aspiration of attracting audiences for it. My issue is finding the right content for the 55 million people that I have. So I have it in reverse. And that's why it's a key issue for us, or for me, or for Yahoo in the region, to find the right talent, or the right product, or the right content that I can happily defend and say, guys, I got you something, it may be there, and it's already there, but you haven't seen it. And here I am exposing the 55 million people to it. So the issue is not just about the quality of content or the volume, it's the issue of guiding the user to the content that we think they would enjoy consuming.